urging Australians to call it out.
I said stop it!
The government's Stop It at the Start campaign promoting a message of respect towards women.
If you see disrespect, unmute yourself.
Its own record in this area, though, still firmly in the spotlight.
Clearly, as a national workplace, the Parliament is starkly not immune. It has to change. It must change.
Just 3 weeks ago, allegations coming to light that a former Liberal staffer was raped by a male colleague in the Defence Minister's office in 2019. The handling of the issue by Linda Reynolds under intense scrutiny, the pressure taking its toll.
Linda has got a very serious medical condition that's currently in the process of being controlled through medication.
And with the Senator extending her medical leave until next month, calls for her resignation are growing louder.
Linda Reynolds' position is simply untenable.
We need a defence minister who can turn up and answer questions in Parliament and in estimate.
But it is, in my view, entirely unreasonable to suggest that a person who is dealing with a health issue should be treated in that way.
Adding to the government's cabinet crisis, historical rape allegations, which the Attorney General strenuously denies. National's MP Barnaby Joyce again breaking ranks, repeating calls for an independent inquiry.
I think that that is a more sustainable and dignified way to go forward, because it will be a mosh pit as soon as Christian sticks his head up down in Canberra.
The government standing firm.
We have very well established judicial and legal processes in this country to deal with matters of criminal allegation.
But the New South Wales Police Commissioner says the case would be difficult to prosecute.
It is not impossible, but almost impossible to proceed with a matter like this without the victim. The matter itself, even with the victim, probably would have struggled to get before a court.
The fallout from this allegation is likely to continue to circle the government, now without two senior ministers, when Parliament resumes next week. Shubha Krishnan, SBS World News.